Last night, I was psychotic. At around 3 a.m, I began to hallucinate. I was delusional, totally believing ridiculous things. I was also disoriented, unsure of who I was or why I was there. However, by 8 a.m, the experience had been forgotten entirely. Amnesia. This will happen again tonight. The combination of this bizarre set of symptoms leaves me with a clear diagnosis. I was sleeping. Not only was I asleep, but I was also dreaming, a condition characterized by seeing things that are not real and believing they are real. Leaving my dreams behind, I want you to contemplate a few questions. Did you get enough sleep last night? Are you tired right now? And if so, do you require caffeine to function on a daily basis? You likely won't be surprised to hear that if you obtain the recommended amount of sleep last night, it puts you in a minority. About 2/3 of Australians fail to obtain 8 hours of sleep each night. John is a 44-year-old truck driver who, like the rest of his colleagues, does require caffeine to function on a daily basis. This is because John's job does not allow for 8 hours of sleep each night, so he uses both legal and illegal artificial stimulants, namely coffee and amphetamines, to stay awake and attentive on the road. But John's kids sometimes avoid him when he's very tired because he might snap at them, and John has been gaining weight since he started his job as a truck driver. John's boss expects him to work hard and thinks John is working harder when he's sleep deprived. John drinks beer before bed on weekends because it helps him fall asleep. Jess is a 17-year-old HSC student at Red Bay High School, who often feels tired during the day but very awake at night. Jess lives a few hours away from the school, so she wakes up early in the morning around 6 a.m, even though she usually goes to bed at 12 or later because it takes a while for her to start feeling tired. She uses the extra time to catch up on schoolwork. She and her friends joke about always forgetting content before a test and sometimes have to pull all-nighters to study. Jess has had mild anxiety for a few years and it seems to be getting worse. Before passing judgment on Jess and John's normalized practices, accounts for some vital facts deeply relevant to the lives of these hypothetical people. Drowsy driving can be more dangerous than drunk driving, causing 1.2 million American car crashes each year. Sleep-deprived drivers fall asleep for long periods at the wheel and cause devastating crashes. A tired person has trouble regulating their emotions. They will be quick to anger and likely to negatively misinterpret others' actions. A sleep-deprived worker is 50% efficient. In businesses, sleep can be treated as a luxury rather than a necessity, resulting in massively more time used for the same job. John's weight gain since starting his new job can be attributed in part to the tendency of a sleep-deprived mind to crave sugary or sweet foods. John's beers before bed will interfere with his sleep and rob him of dreams. Alcohol transforms sleep from a restorative to a sedatory process. Sleep is absolutely essential for the rational and logical thinking Jess is required to do and for all productive and creative processes. Jess will find problem solving much easier when well rested. Effective learning cannot be done without sufficient sleep. Registering, absorbing, and later regurgitating information as separate processes are wholly or partially facilitated by sleeping. Sleep deprivation is known to amplify the effects and development of psychiatric disorders such as anxiety and depression. While teenagers require more sleep than adults, their sleep schedule has also shifted forward a few hours, making it difficult to fall asleep on time and more difficult to wake up early in the morning to go to school. Sleep is integral to healthy body function, and its absence leads to health concerns such as a 40% increased risk of cancer. The good news is that your lack of sleep can be solved with some effort. You can implement simple methods into your life to increase your nightly sleep and improve all aspects of waking life, some of which are mentioned on our government's website. The Australian Government's Activity and Health for Young People website refers to sleep as an afterthought, briefly mentioning sleep as essential to healthy growth. The body uses light to figure out when it's time to sleep. The best way to improve your sleep is to understand this and to use its implications to benefit your sleep. Mimicking natural light conditions involves exposing yourself to bright light throughout the day and ideally engaging in physical activity in the sun. Once the sun sets and you're at home, regulate your exposure to all light, but especially blue light emitted by your devices. I'm not asking you to throw away your devices, simply switch them to nightlight mode so that they emit warm light conducive to sleep. This can be done on your phone and laptop. Do not use your phone before or when in bed. It will keep you up all night. If you usually work out before going to sleep and you notice it affects your ability to do so, try working out earlier in the evening. Finally, make sure you establish a strong sleep routine compatible with your body clock. Early birds may find it easier to fall asleep earlier, while night owls will need to wake up later in the day to get enough sleep. If you're a night owl, do not spend your night hours on devices, as they will only keep you awake longer when your goal is to get as much sleep as possible. If this has been enlightening for you and you would like to know more about the science of sleep and dreams, I strongly recommend Matthew Walker's book, Why We Sleep, which will supply you with all the information you need to understand and implement healthy sleep into your life. And as always, thanks for watching.